Welcome to the Talos Principle. Zones 1 through 4 are completed, so let's move on to zone number 5. And according to the little markings here, this is going to require both cubes and connectors. So I'm going to get to play with my new item. Yay! This place is depressing. Beep boop. You know, I'm pretty sure it's generally a bad idea to have a computer out in the rain. EL. It's an HTML file. Is it a web page? EL, short for Extended Lifespan, is a groundbreaking initiative by 7 leading universities to create the world's most stable and most durable supercomputer. With its custom-made hardware, bomb-proof casing, and near-inexhaustible hydroelectric power supply, EL represents a unique step forward in the evolution of human technology. The brainchild of Nobel Prize nominee Dr. Arkady something-something. Oh yeah, it is actually part of a website. Download press kit, meet the team. Just a bunch of broken HTML crap. Okay, so this is obviously talking about basically the computer system thing that I'm inside of. The brainchild of Nobel Prize nominee Dr. Arkady, who is... if there are any technical issues to resolve, please contact their project lead, Arkady Cherna something. In fact, is he listed here? No. He's not listed here, but he's listed down here. So apparently he is the project lead of the archive team, who are not directly part of their project. So he's related. Let's just go back to that for a second. Yeah, extended lifespan. Most stable and most durable supercomputer. That does seem to go along with the idea of what's going on, where it seems like everything's been going on for so long that stuff is starting to break down. You know, random data corruption because it's been running for so long. The timers for like how long the system was running were pegged at maximum and couldn't go any higher. There was the purging excess data thing. When Elohim purged away the darkness. I think humanity might be dead. This thing might just be running and humanity is dead. And it's still going. That's a depressing thought. Athena. You must consider these riddles. Oh, the Sphinx! Where have we heard about a Sphinx and riddles? In the walkie-talkie from last episode. Okay, my ears have perked up. You must consider these riddles, the Sphinx said, and tell me the riddle that I did not reveal. The Sphinx smiled, the gears in her jaw creaking, her teeth a nightmare of rust. Her left eye flickered, but none of its terror was diminished. The ruins were silent. That's all messed up. I think, she finally said, that the riddle you did not reveal is this. Why do these riddles exist in the first place? Why do these curious automatons, these mute children of Hephaestus, behave as they do, forcing me to devise these intricate solutions? Each is a riddle, but the greater riddle is their purpose. The Sphinx did not answer. Her eye was lifeless now. Athena removed it from its socket, knowing that its power would aid her, yet feeling also a deep sorrow at the passing of this fearful creature. So So that's two times that this riddle of the Sphinx has come up. Once here and then once before in the walkie-talkie. I suppose none of it actually matters until I actually find a Sphinx of some sort. Because there's nowhere I could apply this knowledge, right? But it also seems to be talking about us. The riddle you did not reveal is this: why do these riddles exist in the first place? I mean, that's talking about all this crap, right? Like, why do these puzzles exist? Why am I solving these things? Why does it matter? Why does Elohim want me to do this? Who cares? And why do they care? You know, why am I here? What is the point of my life? It's from Alexandra Drennan. Looks like it's from an article. Reconsider. Once a true artificial intelligence has been created, the issue of citizenship is going to come up. If we acknowledge that the AI has all the abilities of a human brain, should it not be considered a citizen? Is it not, in the legal sense of the word, a person, and thus a potential citizen? But where do you draw the line? Some people will object. Will the great apes become citizens? Elephants? Whales? The more intelligent parrot species? It's crazy, they will say. I would remind these people that we live in a society in which a corporation, as abstract an entity as one could imagine, is considered a person. So it's not like there is no precedent for a non-human being a person. At least an artificial intelligence is an actual thinking being, not just a business arrangement. But perhaps we do need to question the definition of personhood. Increasing amounts of evidence regarding the intelligence of elephants or the existence of culture among whales, for example, could be a sign that we need to answer some difficult questions. Who better to debate these questions with than the young genius who revolutionized the something? The young genius who revolutionized the what? Hold on. Alexandra Drennan, I just want to keep this stuff straight. Isn't she the project lead? Yeah, she is. I thought she was the young genius, wasn't she? Hold on, let's go all the way back, like the very first message. You're so young and you've already accomplished so much. And this is from Nadia to Alexandra Drennan. So yeah, Alexandra Drennan is the young one. She's the one that I think like just recently got out of college or whatever. Recently finished her studies. She's apparently very young, yet for some reason she became the project lead. And in this article, it's Wait, this isn't written by Alexandra Drennan, is it? It's about Alexandra Drennan. Who better to debate these questions with than the young genius who probably is talking about Alexandra Drennan. Yeah, never mind, okay. Yeah, she is the young genius who revolutionized something. I don't know, maybe nomadics, whatever that is. I still forgot to look up that term. I can play in the puddles, yay! What was the key to go third person? There it is. What is that? Paint. What the hell am I gonna do with paint? Okay, so I can just put it down wherever I want. Right. I'm just gonna put this right here. The more I converse with these terminals, the more I wonder what role they play in this contraption. How do you tell friend from foe, when no obvious lines are drawn between the two?
I was in school when I first read about the Talos Principle. I think it disturbed me at the time, made me hyper-aware of my body as a physical object, the material reality of the brain. Ideas that made me uncomfortable at first, but I think in the long run, it helped me understand how frail human beings are and how precious. It's not a comforting way of thinking about the world, but I'd rather face the truth than lie to myself.
Let's start playing with boxes. And let's not go to the red one first, because I think those tend to be harder than the other ones. Although, I'm guessing that based on a precedent of one puzzle that was red, that was hard. So that might not actually be the case. Things to do with two boxes. That's a lot of QR codes. Hello. Oh, that's weird. So it kind of like automatically puts you on top of it? It's really strange. I don't know, it's almost like it prevents you, because there's some weird stuff going on with the character controller, with how it tends to like push you off objects and stuff. I wonder if there's some sort of protection that they programmed into the game, where like it actually recognizes whether you're on top of a box, and if you're not on top of a box, maybe there's like an invisible wall that you can't get over, so you can't like glitch over something. I don't know. Okay, and you can put it on top of another one. That's cool. But if I do that, then I can't actually get up on it. Okay, so it looks like they're explicitly trying to avoid the weird tower of boxes that you sometimes make. So I can't, like, put this half on this box and then, like, jump up to the beginning of this one and then, like, jump up to the next one. So you can't create those awkward towers that tend to topple over. Which is a little bit limiting, but also probably for the best, because it tends to be very finicky and annoying. I remember I experienced making towers in, I think it was Amnesia the Dark Descent. Maybe it was a mod for that or something. Actually, I think it was in the, what was it, like the Justine DLC for that? I remember at one point I needed to like get up to something and I made a huge tower of boxes and it was just ridiculous. I kept falling over and it drove me crazy. But I should be able to do this. Yeah, there we go. Oh, that's, huh. So you can just explicitly jump to somewhere without actually having to like go through the air? Well, that's neat. Yeah, so they're trying to avoid the finickiness of jumping and missing. That's actually really cool. Okay, so can I just jump over the force field? What the hell is this? Oh. It's a pressure plate. That's gotta be the coolest damn pressure plate I've ever seen. Look at that thing. It's got like actuators and stuff. I don't even think those are actuators. I don't even know what that word means, but it sounds cool. And I'm sure it can be weighed down to the box, of course. Alright, what do these say? What's a hexahedron? Hexahedron? However you pronounce that? I don't know, it's a shape, isn't it? A powerful device fashioned by the designer. Is that an answer? A cube. Okay, yeah, so these are answers. This is a conversation. The edges are beveled, that makes it a decahedron. Said always right. Always right has always gotta be right. Fucking asshole. You forgot the indents. With the indents, it's like a super polyhedron. But the convex hole is a decahedron. Topic closed. Wrong. Said dog, which is God backwards. Bickering fools. Alright, I'm trying to think of how I could exploit those boxes to do stuff. Yeah, this is an example of where the character controller really wants to keep you off of stuff. Like, I can't stay on this. It just pushes me off. Grab the other box. It's been a while since I've seen you guys. I'm guessing I can stop them from moving with the box? Yes. Which, actually, is probably all I need to do, because, yeah, that'll make them out of sync. So then I can go between them? Yeah, perfect. Rest in peace, Apis. Oh god, I don't have time to read that. Alright, hold on, I really want to read that. Epitaph, child program, blah blah blah, codename Apis, terminated, logic failed, random memory test, blah! I mean, I suppose I could probably trap it or something. In fact, let's do that. Okay. Epitaph. Child program version blah blah blah, codename Apis, terminated here, logic, failed random memory test, final memory dump. I try, again, again, I cannot understand, I am not enough. Progeny programs, error. I'm sorry, Apis. Rest in peace, Apis. Okay, so where the hell am I going? I mean, I had two boxes, and it seemed like I probably could have used those boxes to get over the gate that would get me to the shape. Although I think I lacked a place to actually jump onto the two boxes from. Okay, yeah. So this is where you're supposed to jump over. And it looks like you just need one. Yep. Yoink. Oh my god, what the hell is going on over there? It's a light show. It's a freaking rave. Alright, so there's my quick escape ladder out. QR code over there, QR code here. It suddenly got brighter. But that's not why I gasped. It's because Gold Star! Why did it suddenly get lighter? Is that a coincidence, or is it because I'm looking at the Gold Star? It's weird. Okay, how do I get there? If I put the box here, I don't think I could jump over. I've probably got to go through that force field, but how do I get to the force field? We'll see. If the designer is perfect, and he designed me for a purpose, I must be fit for that purpose. It follows that my purpose must not be to seek and hoard every sigil in his land, for so many are beyond the faculties he granted me. Oh my god, it's really bright. This dynamic weather is really cool. That reasoning does actually follow. If the designer is perfect, and he designed him for a purpose, then he must be fit for that purpose, right? Well, not necessarily. I guess the designer could be playing a joke or something. But of course, the underlying assumption is that the designer is perfect, which is absurd. Nothing is perfect. Yeah, I can't get over that. So close. Maybe I can glitch it. I'm kind of jumping in midair. Maybe I can glitch it, I don't know. How am I jumping in midair? Hold, let me zoom out, what's happening? I guess I'm not jumping in midair. But my feet are far from clearing this thing. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. I do not understand why the designer chose to put such flaws into the world, that it appears almost as if it were damaged. But I must believe that there is a purpose here I cannot see. Yep, that's the faith personality. Which has a very religious outlook on everything. Is that part of another puzzle? I mean, what is that? Like, how do I even get in there? Because it looks like there's two puzzles, maybe. Like, one puzzle is just getting into the area, and then the other puzzle is actually solving the puzzle. Perhaps I need both boxes? I don't know, because I think if I go up this ladder, I think it just takes me over, doesn't it? Yeah, I can't stay up there. Okay, so it's over there. Is there another puzzle over there? There is. You know, it's probably part of the red one. Maybe. Or maybe you can move the boxes in between levels. Could you, like, throw this over something? If you got near to something, like near the top of something, could you throw it over? I wonder. Hold on, let me test something. I just want to see if I can take this paint with me. You can. Okay. I can't think of a purpose for it, so for now, I'm just gonna Leave it somewhere where I won't forget it. Okay, this is the hard one. I probably shouldn't be in here. But, oh well. Okay, that's a lot of bad stuff, and I only have one jammer. Ooh. The paint might be related to this. Don't know how to even use it. Oh, paint message. I don't think that's related to the paint, though, is it? Has anyone managed to solve this one? A messenger must be awakened first, okay. Yeah, I don't know if I needed that paint. I should have tested it without the paint first. So the gold star, isn't the gold star like over here? I think it is, so it's actually not accessible from here. I think it is supposed to be accessed from the other place. I mean, that's where you see the gold star, so it would make sense. Okay, I need stuff. How in the fuck? Well, I definitely need that box to weigh down that pressure plate, which should allow that to open. And obviously I'm gonna need to disable at least one of these, but I need to disable the other one too if I'm gonna walk across here. Alright, let's just get the box first. I don't think that's gonna allow me to get the box. No, 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 no. I need stuff. How do I get stuff? Those things can be blown up at turrets. So if I want to blow up that turret, I need to move the box, but I can't move the box until I blow up the turrets? Do you think I can get it fast enough? Probably not. This might work. Oh, God. Oh, okay, now the message is not painted. So let me see if I can paint it without paint. I can. Okay, so the paint's not used for that. Yeah. In fact, where did the paint go? Oh, well. I feel like that could have worked, but I don't think it's supposed to. Nah, it's too finicky. I don't think you're supposed to do that. I need to blow it up. I need to get the thing to blow up. Let me just try this. Okay. This doesn't really help. Oh! Yeah, I'll come back here later. The red ones are definitely the hard ones. Okay, we get to use boxes and connectors. So ultimately, I need a connector. Oh yeah, you could put them on top of boxes. Interesting. So is this all I have, though? Just one connector and one box? It is. Okay, could I move it? Tricky bastards. Well, I could just move the whole thing right there, right? Yeah, it's got a clear shot to it. Okay. I can't grab it. Bingo! I think it's starting to rain again. You mustn't cross the streams. So we're doing a stream crossing thing again, except I'm assuming this time I need to use the boxes to get them to not cross streams. Aw, it's all gloomy again. Any secrets over here in the woods? Why did everything just go like white for a second? Oh, that was just the thunder, wasn't it? Or the lightning, rather. I think there might be like a walkie-talkie on the ground or something, but it's so hard to see. I wish I had a flashlight. Okay, so a red beam to get the other stuff. Which, of course, they put the red beam connector thing on the opposite side of this thing, which means, yeah. But of course I can use the box for that, so we go ahead and do this. Pretty again. Okay, that's a little bit disturbing, because that kind of traps me inside, but I just want to peek over. For any gold stars. Nope. I guess I'll put this back the way I found it. Okay, I think there's one more before the red one. One little buzzer. I think something's very wrong. If you'd seen what I'd seen at the edges of the world, you'd wonder if it wasn't stretching and bursting at the seams. Oh, I've seen some weird stuff. What the hell is that? Never seen that before. You don't look friendly, though. Okay, so you don't seek me out. You look like you explode if I touch you. Okay. So you do a little bit of damage, but not much. Well, this just seems too easy. Are you gonna, like, absorb the energy of the beam and do something? Let's see what happens when it crosses. Oh, it's never gonna... Son of a bitch. Hold on. Clever bastards. Alright, it's gonna give it as much time as possible. I might be able to get inside with that, maybe. But that's obviously not what you're supposed to do. Yeah, I'm sure I'm supposed to block it. There we go. I can feel its silent frustration. Poor thing. Oh, I was thinking maybe I could use you guys as, like, jumping off points. Well, I mean, it shoots me forwards, not really up, though. Yeah, that doesn't really work. And this is just to escape in case it closes behind me, I suppose? Yeah. Yeah, this dynamic weather is really cool. I'm thinking of ways I can break the level. What can I do with this box? Nothing I can think of. Because, I mean, maybe I can look over the level geometry and, like, the walls and, put the connector on top of the box and maybe, like, power something up over a wall or something. That's what I keep thinking of. Okay, I think that's it except for the red one. And there's either something I'm missing about the red one, like, there's something I'm missing inside of the level, or perhaps I do actually need to do something outside of that particular level. Like, throw a box over a wall or something. And what the hell is this paint for? I don't know. But I think I'll save this one for next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.